We used a pegboard kit to add some functionality to our New Age Bold Series 3.0 garage cabinets, and it looks pretty good as well. So stick around and I'll show you how we did it. What's going on, adventurers? My name's Travis. Welcome back to another project. About a month ago, my wife and I installed our brand new Age Bold Series 3.0 garage cabinets you can see here behind me. They are a breeze to use, and they've really cleaned up the look of our garage by just tidying up and organizing all the loose things we had sitting around. Now, we made a full video showing the entire setup process, from unboxing the cabinets, mounting them to the walls, and then I also did a full tour of all the functionality of the cabinets. If you haven't checked out that video, I'll post a link up here as well as in the description below so you can check it out. Now, in that video, we featured our pegboard setup that we had installed behind our New Age cabinets. I've been getting a bunch of questions specifically about the pegboard, so I thought I'd make a video just talking about the pegboard itself. So that's what today's video is all about. I'm gonna be talking about why I went with pegboard instead of a different setup, what comes with this kit, and more importantly, where you can get this kit. So if you're new to the channel, we are all about projects that add adventure to your life. The behind the scenes stuff that make your next adventure possible. If you haven't already, please take a second, hit that subscribe button. We'd really appreciate the support. And remember to click that little bell icon to be notified every time we drop a new video. So let's jump into this project. See the way these New Age Bold Series 3.0 cabinets mount with the overhead cabinets and this tabletop here. It makes a really nice space to mount your pegboard. Now, this space measures about 8 feet by 2 feet, and our pegboard panels are 2 foot by 1 foot, so we had to use a total of 8 panels. Now, New Age makes something that they call a slat wall. You can order it. It's the perfect dimensions for your kit. It consists of a bunch of tracks, and the hangers just slide into those tracks. Now, I decided to go a bit of a different direction. I decided to go with this pegboard for a reason. Slat wall allows you to customize a fair amount, but with something like pegboard, because the holes are so much closer together, you can really dial in where your tools sit. One of the best examples are my screwdrivers I have hanging up here. Now, with the pegboard holes, I could have had the hangers sitting right next to each other, but with the different lengths of screwdrivers, I decided to move one of the hangers up one hole, and that just made it a little easier and a little more pleasing to the eye. Just everything looked a little bit more level. You know, the different brands of screwdrivers are slightly different lengths, have slightly different handles. So by moving that hanger up one pin, it just made it look really nice. The other part I like about pegboard is it's a standardized size. So if you go to pretty much any hardware store, you can find different hooks or containers, and you know that they'll fit no problem. Slat wall seems to have that ability as well, but pegboard has just been around for so long, it's really easy to find all the hooks. So let's talk about this kit specifically. This kit is actually 2 kits. Each individual kit comes with 4 panels of pegboard, as well as a bunch of hooks and hangers and containers. So because it was necessary to have 8 panels, we ordered 2 kits to cover this gap. Now, when installing this pegboard, when we measured the opening for our New Age Bold Series cabinets, it actually measured 8 feet by 23 inches. I was a little bit confused by that until I realized that the tabletop is about 1 inch thick. So we had to undo the tabletop and slide it back, That way we are able to mount our pegboard to the wall. Now this pegboard kit, once you mount all the panels together, isn't quite a full 8 feet. So we centered it and we had about 1.5 to 2 inches on either side of the pegboard. So this meant when we slid the tabletop back and remounted it, we had a bit of a gap at the back of the tabletop on either side. Now this gap is actually pretty handy. What it allows you to do is pass cords down through it. So like here with our stereo, we had to run the power cord up to the stereo. So that little gap allowed us to run that power cord up really easy. Now we have that gap on either side of our pegboard, but if you had moved that entire pegboard setup all the way over flush against one of the cabinets on the other side, you probably have about a 4-inch gap. Now if you wanted to be able to pass a plug or full power cord down through it, you might be able to do it if you did it that way. This kit is fairly easy to mount. Like I said, they're 2-foot by 1-foot panels. So once you measure and figure out just exactly where you're going to set these panels up, you can hold one of the panels up and the outermost holes on the panels, you just put a screw through each one of those corners. So using the panel as a guide, if you have a friend hold it up, you can just drill a hole through each one of those corners. The kit comes with drywall anchors and screws, so then you can mount each panel to the wall. We just made sure to have a level on hand to make sure everything was going together nice and square. Couple little adjustments here or there because you're gonna have the lines in between the panels, so you wanna have nice straight lines. Now, probably the piece of information you've all been waiting for. The brand of this kit is Mastercraft. We picked it up at Canadian Tire, but for those of you that aren't here in Canada, I was able to find a really similar set on Amazon. I'll post a link in the description below so you can check it out. Looking through the contents of the kit, it looks more or less identical to this one. So really, I think they're pretty much interchangeable. So like I said, this kit comes with all the panels, but then it comes with a ton of hangers and hooks. We used a bunch and mounted all our odd-shaped tools. We've got our level, some big C-clamps, just a bunch of different stuff mounted on this pegboard. We still have a room to mount a few more, but we just have a ton of hooks left over. You can see there are just a pile of different options you have here, different lengths. So these kits don't cheap out on the hardware they give you. These kits also came with these little plastic bins. I think there was 8 in total. That was the only thing that I had a bit of an issue with these kits. So the bins came stacked up in the kit. And the way they mount to the pegboard are just little plastic tabs. So with them being all stacked up, I think they got jostled around and those plastic tabs, a bunch of them were broken off. Some of the comments on the Amazon kit there, sounds like people were having the same issue. So I think out of the total of 8, we had about 3 that were still working. Now, I wasn't too worried about it because I was more concerned about getting the actual pegboard for it, and these plastic bins were a nice extra. But I probably wouldn't be putting too much weight into them because the way they mount to the pegboard is just those little plastic clips. I know if you like the look of these bins, there's a ton of options out there, and most of them actually have some sort of either metal pins that go into the pegboard or a bit of a basket or just something that offers a little more stability. So that's it for this brief walkthrough of our pegboard we set up behind our New Age Bold Series 3.0 cabinets. You can see the pegboard looks awesome. It was really easy to set up and it offers a ton of functionality, you know, to be able to hang those odd shaped tools. Plus, it just completes the look of the cabinets. I really like the way it looks. You know, the extra color from the tools just kind of brightens it up and makes it a little more lively. So I hope I was able to answer at least most of the questions you guys had from that last video. But if I missed any, please post a comment below. So if you're interested in this pegboard setup, remember I'll post a couple links in the description below so you can check it out. If you've enjoyed this video, please take a quick second, hit that subscribe button. I'd appreciate the support. This channel would appreciate the support. And remember to take a second, hit that bell icon to be notified every time we post a new video. You can keep up to date with all the cool projects we have coming down the line. So thanks for joining me today for this video, but I hope to see you back again real soon for another adventure project.